Policies of Nawaz Sharif 1990 to 1993 and 1997 to 1999. Background. He was born in Lahore in 1949. He acquired his early education from St. Anthony School. He did his graduation in law from the Punjab University. In 1981, he became the finance minister in the Punjab cabinet. In 1985, he won the elections with an overwhelming majority and became the chief minister of Punjab. In 1988, he also became the caretaker chief minister after Ziaul-Haq dissolved the assembly. After the 1988 election, he also has sworn as Punjab chief minister. In 1990, he won the elections, formed the government and became the prime minister of Pakistan. In 1993, he was dismissed from his position before completing his five-year tenure. In 1997, his party Pakistan Muslim League won the elections and he again became the Prime Minister of Pakistan. However, the history repeated itself and in 1999, his government was overthrown by a military coup. Policies of Nawaz Sharif. He reversed the nationalization policy introduced by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto and also countered its effect. He initiated a national reconstruction program to develop the industry. During his rule, PTCL, two banks and more than 50 industrial units were privatized. He restored the confidence in the private sector and reduced the burden from the national treasury. He initiated Ghazi Barotha hydropower project that could produce 1450 megawatts. He constructed the first motorway in Asia between Lahore and Islamabad that resulted in an improved travel system. He acknowledged the water distribution issue among all the four provinces by the Water Apportionment Accord that was the award of the National Finance Commission. He introduced the 13th Amendment in the Constitution and replaced the 8th Amendment that had given extensive powers to the President. As a result, original Constitution of 1973 and political stability was restored. Shortcomings of Nawaz Sharif's rule, both tenures. The failure of cooperative societies. The cooperative societies were responsible for accepting deposits from members, providing loans for businesses, and were state-owned. However, these societies failed to function properly because of mismanagement, and the Sharif family received all the funds. As a result, the poor lost all their savings. In 1991, the Shariat Bill was passed to enforce the Shariat law, but no effort was made to implement it. This bill also received criticism from political parties because of the influence of religion in politics. The ulamas also criticized it because no real effort was made for its enforcement. In 1993, Nawaz Sharif failed to form a cordial relationship with the President Ishaq Khan. Nawaz Sharif wanted to replace the 8th Amendment in the Constitution to limit the powers of the President, and he wanted to appoint the army chief of his choice. However, the president was apt in his decisions, and before Nawaz could do anything, he appointed General Waheed Kakkar as army chief. This conflict among the premier and the president weakened the government. During his second tenure, Nawaz Sharif dismissed General Jahangir Karamat that damaged civil-military relationships and paved the way for military intervention in the government. Fall of Nawaz's premiership, 1993. His yellow cab scheme failed that was supposed to offer taxi drivers soft loans and easy installments. This scheme failed because his government failed to collect installments that created an economic crisis in the country. Nawaz's family did embezzlement in the cooperative society's fund. Conflicts with President Ishaq Khan along with his poor governance led to his dismissal from the office in 1993. 1999. He did a conspiracy against General Musharraf when he was returning from Sri Lanka. His plane was not allowed to land. Nawaz also replaced General Musharraf with that time's ISI chief Ziauddin Butt. This conspiracy made the elite officers of the army agitated, and they retaliated by planning the removal of Nawaz from the office. In reflection on Nawaz's action, commanders took over PTV, Karachi Airport, and the Nawaz Sharif, the Prime Minister. The military started a covert operation with the support of local fighters and successfully captured the heights in Kargil. For Kargil operation, Nawaz Sharif blamed Musharraf and accused the military that he was not involved in the planning or the operation. The Kargil operation and its aftermath created serious conflict between the military and civil government, and it led to the military coup. If you like this video, don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram and LinkedIn, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.